six.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. And he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. Give him 30 yards there.
And let's face it, that what we just saw there, not a surprise, is it? I mean, this is what he does well. And if you don't tackle him as soon as he catches the ball, this is the end result. Big yardage afterwards.
Got the speed, the agility, so good with run after catch. Him only in the first quarter, so they better get a wrangle and a hold on that quickly.
Yeah, you're exactly right. What's really difficult to try and defend him is if you want to press him so that you get him on the ground quickly after the catch, a lot of times he'll just run past you at the initial point of contact, and he'll go deep.
It's an 8-yard pickup, and it'll make it a second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
The Jags with their first opportunity in the red zone. They come up first and 10 at the 16. Now they try the right side here. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A great play there. A 16-yard touchdown run. And the Jags have taken the early lead. And now a two-point conversion attempt forthcoming. Not gonna make it. They stop him up short, and this will remain a 6-0 ball game. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10.
They were going to 53. We got three.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And he'll get this way down into Jacksonville territory. A big play there. 51 yards. At 6'6 and nearly 270 pounds, when a ball goes in the air for Rob Gronkowski, seems like most people always bet on him.
And rightly so. I can't imagine how you can make a play on the ball that's going to affect him. He seems to just kind of shrug off defenders. And you talk about uncovered downfield. Yeah, he just puts a hand up and says, throw it. I'm going to go get it.
And a nice pick up there. He gets about 5 down to the 4-yard line. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yeah, it's now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try to put it in that way.
Prescott, incomplete. His favorite target, Travis Kelce, the intended receiver. And it'll bring up third down.
Brandon, some of those windows that throw the football that exist when you're between the 20s, they don't exist when you're this close to the goal line. But as a former DB, I liked it closer to the goal line. Tighter windows made it easier to cover people, actually.
And he'll get it down close to the goal line, but not quite in. This defense bending but not breaking. It's a gain of 3. It's now fourth and goal. They'll go with a big back Fournette, and he is into the end zone for a touchdown. A great effort there, taking it in from a yard out. And his guys are an extra point away now from taking the lead. Now Steven Goskowski on for the extra point. Extra point good by Goskowski, and they take the lead here at 7-6. is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Out comes the Jacksonville offense as they get set to take over here. Throwing on first down, Lambert. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive, and also give him a first down. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play, and that'll make it second and 12.
Back 99, Philly, here we go. Watch it now, Barney, Barney. Gun, 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 gun.
Back to throw, Lambert. And he's got a man on the crossing route, that's Moore. His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
They go play action here on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess.
Detroit! Detroit!
To throw again, Lambert. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Put a check mark in the box where the defense coordinator was saying, how well can we stay with these receivers if we're in man coverage? Because he just did it on that one. Force the incompletion. That allowed him to get bolder with his pass rush, won't it?
Absolutely. Frees up your guys elsewhere. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. From the gun, Lambert. No, bottled up. Fumble. It's out. It's loose. And the defense has come up with it.
With no running backs in the backfield to help pass protect, all the receivers in their patterns, these are going to be hot routes. If they sense a blitz or pressure on the quarterback, they've got to be prepared to break routes off early and get the football. In this case, never even had a chance. They popped the ball free in the backfield.
Prescott now after the fumble recovery. Flush to his right. Open man right side is Smith-Schuster, complete. And he'll get it down here to the 43. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. He was looking for any help. I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
46.
A second down throw for Prescott. That's complete. It's Gordon. He had over 100 catches in the regular season, and now he's got his first catch of this wild card game. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart, because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield.
Prescott looks to throw on first. And that is in. Josh Gordon, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. Before the game, they were running the route tree about as efficiently and effectively as we could have possibly imagined, but sometimes the passes just go awry.
Yeah, let's face it. When you're running the route tree in pregame, you don't have defenders breathing down your neck. You don't have defensive backs making plays on the football. Hard to replicate the intensity of the game in pregame.
They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down. The last catch nearly got them at first, but it did not, and they'll try to convert on third and inches. They'll try and run for it with Fournette, and he gets this down to the 18, good enough for a first down. They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive going. Prescott on first down. And he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. It'll be a gain of 9, and it'll be second and about a yard. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. A great play there with his second touchdown here in this first half. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. Gostkowski, the extra point. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Off the play fake, Lambert. And he's going to be wrapped up and driven down.
Oh, my goodness. Was that a defensive back that got to him with the pressure?
Oh, look at the former defensive back. You're all smiles up here.
I hope everybody can hear my smile on that play.
And on the ground they go with a running back. And he'll work this one up to about the 38. They get 6 yards back on the run, but still have a third and long situation forthcoming.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Looking to throw, Lambert over the middle into traffic, and that's complete. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. They do get 9, but it leads to fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. Looking right. And this is going to come up well short as they stop him on fourth down. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the ball will go over on downs on the short side of the field. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. First down, Prescott. Wide open, Gronkowski. Touchdown! Rob Gronkowski, 42 yards. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails? Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. And now out come the Jags. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild
Green,
that confidence.
39. Green, 39.
They'll run it now out of the gun, and he finds enough of an opening to get this one back up to his 20. On the defensive end, Cameron Sutton with a tackle.
Oh, boy, I know you felt that one.
2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back with more AFC playoff action after this timeout.
Watch it now, Barney! Barney!
Mike, 55. Right there in the middle, 55.
Gun! 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 Gun!
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll power his way up near the 25. Kenny Clark, the big D tackle there to make the stop. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. They'll run it now out of the gun. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively, and it likely forces a punt situation on fourth.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Now, the offense failed earlier on the previous crack at this, but they're going again on fourth down.
Right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. Gun, gun. Gun, gun.
They're going to try and throw. Looking left side of his guy, man. It's Reese. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
Right,
that one good for 17 yards on fourth. Couldn't ask for much more from your offense there. First down. On first and 10, Lambert looking for his running back, and he's got it. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3. Operating from the gun, Lambert. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Linval Joseph, able to collapse the pocket and drop him for a loss of a yard. The Jaguars on third down, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and 4. Back to throw. Lambert forced out to his left. Open man is Pettis. It's complete. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. To go in this first half.
Detroit! Detroit!
On first down, Lambert escaping the pressure right. And oh, he coughed it up! And does the defense have it? They do, says the referee. We're going the other way.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk-reward. I don't know about you, but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit, and in this case, lose the football.
So, should have gone down. I mean, hindsight's always 20-20, but that's the safe play.
You're exactly right. Hindsight's really never wrong, is it? Because you can analyze it.
And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. after the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Prescott from the gun, flushed out right, and he goes down. It's a sack. They get him back at his own 3-yard line. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. Final play of the half. Prescott dumps it off to Fournette. And they're going to take a timeout defensively. So with fourth down coming up, they go ahead and burn it and say we'll see what happens. Now here's Michael Dixon as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. Touchdown just shy of midfield. So we're at halftime of this AFC wild card matchup. As we send you a couple hours south of here to Orlando, that's where we check in with a coach and our EA Sports halftime report. Teams try to avoid being one and done in these playoffs as we start the second half of this AFC wild card game. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. So here they come, the road team now getting the football first to start this third quarter. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, you feel like you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
It's still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 48-yard line. They'll run it now out of the gun. Just what you want on a first down run, call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Prescott now on second down, flush to his right. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. 4 yards there as they let him out of the pocket, and he got enough for the first.
That's something we have not seen him do to this point, and that's take the ball, tuck it, and run.
Exactly right. His first carry of the game. I guess he picked a good time to do it.
He certainly did. Not only did he have the element of surprise, he's making sure he's judicious in taking off.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop him. On first and 10, Prescott eluding the pressure right. And this is Gabriel on the catch. And down inside the 15 he goes. 10 more there and another first down.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
From the red zone now, Prescott. He'll check this one off to Fournette. It'll be a gain of 4, and it's a second down. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
And he maneuvers his way down to the 3-yard line. It's a 6-yard run, leaves him with about a foot or so here still to go to hit the marker with third down coming up.
46.
There we go. They stay on the ground. This time it's Johnson. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. David Johnson, a 3-yard touchdown run. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. The point after try for Gostkowski. Gostkowski with the extra point. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the Jags offense now. Time for their first possession of half number two. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Throwing on first down, Lambert. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Love his pocket awareness, able to slip out of the sack. But once you take your eyes off the receivers, once your eyes come down and you see the rush, hard to get back downfield and find an open target. Fortunate, that one just wound up as an incomplete pass.
Back to the air on second down. Lambert, and he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. To throw on third down, Lambert steps away to his left. And now another one thrown incomplete.
Well, we're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. And they're going to fake it from deep in their own territory. Going absolutely nowhere. He'll wind up losing a yard or two. A little trickeration there, but it doesn't fool him. It's such a risky play there to fake it. You're either the hero or the goat. Here they're going to be the goat.
Unfortunate, too, because you know they thought they had something there. They don't call it just a call. They don't just say, oh, what the heck, let's go ahead and fake it here. They feel like they've got something on. They've got the defense in the right spot. Just unsuccessful in that opportunity.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Second down, Prescott. Escaping the pressure right. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete. Looking for his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. And now it's third down.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow,
he rifles one that's intercepted. Picked by Ronnie Harrison. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. And they needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the third quarter. Defensively, they did that. Now they got to go quickly and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and saying, guys,
let's go.
Come on, capitalize on this one.
Play action, Lambert. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. He has still not connected on a single pass in this second half.
And right now they're going through all the different reasons, the whys, the wherefores. Bottom line,